champions in what has been an electric final news conference here from the MGM Grand, getting set to host its 14th heavyweight championship fight, and this will be only the third heavyweight championship rematch in history after a draw in the first fight. Deontay Wilder, the undefeated WBC heavyweight champion, now joined by his longtime trainer, JD, is out of Tuscaloosa, Alabama, and the undefeated lineal heavyweight champion, Tyson Fury, with the guy who's going to be the chief second for the first time in a fight with Tyson, and that is from the famed Kronk Gym, Sugar Hill Stewart. Gentlemen, thank you for joining us. I wanted to get into fight strategy right away, but this took such a different turn today compared to the tone that we've seen in most of the promotion for this fight that I will start with simply asking you your reaction to what you've seen out of your two fighters here in the course of the past 45 minutes. Jay?
It's appalling. It's horrible. It's fight week. This is what's supposed to happen. You know, it's one thing when it's 3 months out, 2 months out, but When it's that week, it's supposed to get like this. This is what happens when you have the two best heavyweights in the world, both undefeated, both highly motivated, both as competitive as two humans on earth can be. This is what happens. I wouldn't expect anything less.
Sure.
I'm excited about it, watching the fighters' reactions. Everything's been quiet. Everything's been subtle. Today you saw the mood swings, you saw all the hard work that these fighters have been putting into their training camps. You just saw a little glimpse of it on the stage here. The emotions are going up, the emotions are going down. Emotions are going up, they're going back down. This is what big time boxing is. These two guys are professional, but they still have their emotions, they still have their the chip on the shoulder. They both want that win. Both of these fighters are just, expressing themselves like they should.
Sugar, you're one of the biggest variables in this entire lead up to this fight because the news of Ben Davison being out, still a great relationship, it has been proven that your former trainer with you. But here we go, nearly a decade ago, you came over stateside and you spent time in Detroit at the famed Kronk with the late, great Emanuel Stewart, Sugar's uncle, and you formed a bond, also with your cousin Andy Lee, who will be working in the corner with Sugar Hill. Why the return to Kronk?
Because like I said many, many times in the build-up to this fight, what I did last time clearly wasn't good enough. So we have to change it up, and we're gonna look for the knockout, and who better or what better club to go to than
What do you feel like you delivered over the course of the last 8 weeks to Tyson, sure?
I feel like I delivered everything that he asked for. He wanted to be better technical. He wanted to be more aggressive. He wanted to be a big, tall, dominant heavyweight.
Well, you guys have specialized in that for years with the heavyweights who have come out of your camp.
Jay, what was your reaction to the
train? Ain't doing much. Take a step back. Cause it's Elie Seckbach.